Good afternoon, Dell fans, and welcome back to our last interview of Dell Tech World here in fabulous Las Vegas, Nevada. My name is Savannah Peterson. Absolutely thrilled to be joined with the one and only Jackie McGuire for this segment.
What's up, twin?
I know, I'm so pumped. We get to close out the show together. We've had a great time in the analyst program all week.
And, we have.
And this is just a fun one. You've had a lot of influence, and there's literally no one else I would rather have on this desk right now for this final segment as we take it across the line than Bob. Bob, what a pleasure. Great to have you back on the show.
Thank you, great to be here.
How are the boys doing? We talked about your three boys last time.
Boys are doing great. I got one here, he's running around crazy.
Right, he was at the show last year too, right?
Yep, he's here. The other two were, you know, making things happen in headquarters and all over the country, so it's been great. That, love having the family close to their business.
It touched me, I remembered that from last year, and I thought it was real sweet. We gave him a shout out on the show last time, if you recall, which was really, really touching. Bob, it feels like the entire world has changed since the last time you and I were sitting on this news desk.
Yes.
Just 12 short months ago.
Yeah.
Talk to me about what's going on at Future Tech and in your world in the interim there.
Yeah, like we've changed a lot too in the last year. You know, a lot of excitement for us around this event. You know, we were Dell's Federal Partner of the Year.
Oh my gosh, congratulations, I didn't know
you.
That. That's a big deal.
Yeah, so that's their top award for all the federal partners. So we're really excited about that, very well earned. It'll be interesting to see next year based on all the geopolitical fun that's going on, how that
looks. That is one way to put it.
What are you talking about?
Oh,
what are you talking about?
Couple of things going on, but it's been great. You know, we've done a lot from a change perspective in the organization from last year to this year. You know, we hired a CRO, somebody who'd been at Dell for 18 years, and then he brought on an entire team of folks based on, you know, Dell making some adjustments to their staff and employees based on, you know, their embracing of AI and using AI to do a lot of the work. There were some, you know, transitions around people, and those people have come to Future Tech. So I think in the last 2 months, we've added like 60 people into the Future Tech.
Oh my God, hey,
that's crazy.
I'm going to give you a little shout for that.
Yeah, a little shout. My CFO is like, no. But it's been good, but we're trying to really set ourselves up for the pace of change that's going to be coming, right? And a lot of
that's
the announcements.
Already here.
Yeah, it is amazing how quickly things are moving right now.
Isn't it wild? We've never moved faster. It's such a cool time to have our jobs.
Absolutely, 100%. It's cool, but we definitely are going to be on
for the
next,
baby.
You know, probably 2-3 years on making these things work and happen.
Yeah,
you know,
I think as
there.
My friend Joe Hall puts it, we fly very close to the sun in
this
business.
Yeah.
My ass
candle gets burnt sometimes. So.
Yeah.
I felt a little burnt this morning.
I'm just gonna no comment on that one, folks.
Yeah.
Just gonna no comment.
And I'm in Fort Lauderdale, so it takes a lot to burn.
Yeah. So you get to see a lot of different tech and work with a lot of different companies and what y'all do. What are some of the trends that you're seeing right now?
Well, I mean, look, obviously, and I think we said this a little bit last year, AI is the theme of the conference.
Right.
Right? And, you know, last year was a little bit more theoretical.
Agreed.
This year, it's practice, right? It is absolutely here, it's happening. We're seeing it in all of the things as it relates to, you know, chat, automation, right? The driving of the technology that's happening across the entire globe from an AI perspective. GPUs, large language models, it's crazy. So like last year was theory, now it's in practice, right? And now it's how do we make those things work within the organizations that we support and really trying to identify what AI actually is.
Right.
Because it's kind of like that,
it's
you know.
It's Kit from Knight Rider, right?
Yeah.
That's what I want.
Exactly. Well, I have a Tesla Cybertruck and I don't drive anymore. Right, the AI is so good, and I put in the address and I just sit back.
Yeah.
You know, this is really, really cool. And you know, that's tied to a lot of the technology that we're doing and supporting, and even, you know, NVIDIA and Dell and the GPUs. But the ecosystem is growing amazingly of these partners.
That's what I think has been one of the, I'm glad you brought that up, Bob, because one of the things that's been remarkable that I've noticed is the ecosystem play here. And I feel like with the Dell AI Factory, Dell was really going out in front. I mean, I remember I was joking with Michael last year, he had Jensen and Bill McDermott on stage with him, and I was like, oh yeah, it's just you and all your billionaire friends having, you know, coming up with the solution of the future, but we're seeing a level of co-innovation and collaboration that we haven't seen historically, and it's actually creating far better solutions. It's it's very interesting.
And it's a better model, because I think historically the partner model has always been very, like, you have to pick one, right? And I think Dell is in this really amazing position where they can say, no, we're going to work with everybody.
Yeah.
And because almost nobody can keep up with Dell on the hardware side, like, they get to choose that. And I think, you know, I always talk about the art of war, and if we want to beat our enemies, we need to think like our enemies. And I don't see a lot of hackers and threat actors out there gatekeeping information. They open source everything. They share everything in forums, you know, and if we want to beat them, we have to stop this whole, like, you know, the ecosystem can only be you and your two favorite partners. It can't be like that.
Yeah, so. Agreed. Right, and that's, you know, it's a game changer, the announcements that Dell made, right, around the, we'll call it the hypervisor hell, right, that is out there that our customers are all experiencing right now, where, you know, we won't name the company, is, you know, strong-arming a lot of the individuals, corporations, and Dell's, you know, approach on making that open and giving choice, right, is tremendous for the partners, but also for the customers that are served. And I think that's going to be key to Dell's continued growth and success in the environment. The AI factory is genius, right? Because it takes a lot of the guesswork out of what people need to do, and we're adopting that. So we're working with Dell on taking an AI factory and making it a AI proving ground. So we're going to take the AI factory, we're going to then go to our customer, and we're going to say, what are the use cases you're trying to do? What are the success criteria you want? I'm going to give you the factory for free.
Yeah.
We're going to test it, we're going to vet it, and then based on the success of what we do, then you're going to consume it, right? So it helps them in driving the direction they want to go from an AI perspective, because AI could have been like, you know, when it was cloud. Well, what's cloud? And what's cloud to you?
Oh my gosh,
right? And then AI, and now what's AI to you, right? And so really understanding and defining that is key, right, to driving some of these things that we're doing.
No, it is. I actually love that you brought up the cloud analogy. Actually, I threw a party many years ago titled F the Cloud, because I was like, it's just a rack of servers in the middle of Kansas. Like,
somebody else's computer.
This isn't a thing, you know, it's so relevant that you brought that up, because to your point, we were talking about all this hype and all this hypothetical, right? And that's sort of why that term cloud was invented, is we needed something to attach to this different type of storage, which was a little bit different. So I'm pumped, because you have such a great lens on the landscape. What are some of the really exciting use cases or success stories that you've been seeing recently?
You know, so I think when we look at things, edge is becoming very, very important, right?
Yes.
And we always talk about PC is so important to us, and we've always been on that that bandwagon of PC is probably one of the most important tools outside of your employees. And people are like, how could you say that? Why would you say that? I'm like, well, how do you access the most important information you have in your company? How do you access your ERP? How do you access your factory floor systems, right? Everything's done via a PC. Now, taking that PC and enabling it to do more, to being intelligent, to having a, you know, GPU, an NPU, and a CPU, and having the ability to do more of those things at the edge and empower the people to be even better and stronger, it's just amazing. So we're seeing a lot of thought and adoption around how do we empower at the edge? How do we leverage the models that we do? But security is key to that, right?
Yes.
And the security around how do we protect the data? Mm-hmm. You brought up bad actors, right? The bad actors don't give a crap, right?
Yeah.
It's they're going to do whatever they need to do. There are not going to be any guardrails around what they're going to do. We need to be able to air gap, to firewall, and to make sure that your data is protected and safe. And if you don't do that as an organization, then you're putting yourself at risk. So many companies are just letting their employees go out on chat and putting their data and their information. Hey, does this Word document look good?
Yeah.
That has proprietary, and that becomes available.
A conversation Jackie and I have all the time.
I had a marketing manager tell me one time that it was okay they were using ChatGPT, their own personal account, to sort through a contact list for customers, because they told it to only return the ones that said
yes. Oh, I just
felt
that in my heart.
Yeah.
He's like, but I told it to filter only by the ones who said yes, we could contact them. And I'm like, but you still put all the ones that said no into ChatGPT.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think, so let me ask you though, we spent the last 10 years, and hundreds of billions of dollars because everything was going to live in the cloud. Are you seeing pushback to the, hey, guess what? Now we're going to move back to the edge. Like, does it make sense to customers? Like, are they salty about it? Because I'm a little salty about it.
So here's how we look at it. We have always maintained that on-prem was the best way to go. Yeah. Now, with some caveats. So we'll do a business analysis and we'll say, okay, how much does it cost you if that application is down per minute?
Right.
If it's $2, put it in the cloud. Mm-hmm. If it's $1 million a minute, keep it on-prem, mm-hmm. build your guardrails around it, secure your data and your information, because if that goes down, and it will, right, in the cloud, there will be an outage,
right?
Then what are you going to do? How do you answer to it? How do you control it? There will be, and I say this to everybody I've talked to here at the show, all of our customers, and we have over 100 customers here.
Oh, fun.
What is, right, do you believe that there will be an outage, that there will be a major event? Yes.
Yeah.
And there will be, because if you look at the bad actors, are they going after the small on-prem company or environment? No, they're trying the hyperscalers. They're attacking AWS, they're attacking Azure, they're attacking Google Cloud, right? They're hitting all these things. And when there is an example of a major outage, CrowdStrike?
Yeah, I was going to say, I know, yeah.
Right?
Elephant in the room there.
Yeah, you're going to be down. And when you're down, are you going to be able to recover?
Right.
No, because I was sleeping on the floor of the Raleigh airport.
Yeah, right? And right, so those are the things that companies have to look at. And look, what we've done and Dell has done to empower that is the consumption models, right? To be able to do on-prem, but consume it by the drink. Because that's what customers want, right? Why did you go to the cloud? It was easier, right?
Right.
Number one. It was less expensive, and they realized it wasn't.
Until you need to move that data back and forth, or between clouds.
Bingo.
Like, I wrote 3 years ago, I was like, we have over-rotated to the cloud. We're doing like regex and like data processing in the cloud. That can all happen at the edge with a little bit of observability and redundancy. Yeah. Like, this makes no sense to me.
It's insane. And customers that put development in the cloud.
Yeah.
So dev, and what is dev? Back and forth, back and forth, back and forth.
100%.
You know, cha-ching, 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 right, each time. So on-prem, we're seeing a big move back. We're seeing a lot of companies and CIOs saying, hey, we need to figure out how to get off cloud and be less reliant on cloud, right?
Yeah.
And deciding what applications that need to go that direction. So that's a big piece of what we're doing.
Yeah, from the research I've seen, it's between 75 and 85% of executives saying that they're moving things back on-prem.
Yeah.
Which is so interesting, and I mean, on-prem can be an edge device, depending on the situation as well, which makes so much sense. An interesting intersection of the AI PC right now. Bob, I got one final question for you, and I'm so keen to hear your answer, because so much has changed since the last time you and I sat here. What do you hope to be able to say when we're at Dell Tech World 2026 that you can't yet say today?
That was federal partner 4 years in a row, because it's three. that would be cool. What I'd love to be able to say is that the actions that we took in designing from an infrastructure, from a support perspective, from an AI enablement, have actually happened, and customers are seeing the ROI, right, that they expected. And we're in a much safer place as it relates to that. And the diversity around the hypervisors has been able to scale, right?
Yeah.
And I think if we can pull those things together, you know, the ramp is going to be insane. The other thing I will mention, I know, is that what Dell has done recently with creating the opportunity where you have a 7-to-1 ratio, right, around the old infrastructure to the new, can make a huge financial impact to the cost that the software suppliers are providing at the core level, right? Everybody's moved to how many cores? Okay, we're going to charge you per core. Mm-hmm. We have a customer that has 300,000 cores, right? So if they have 300,000 cores, and let's say VMware does $300 a core, that's a reoccurring major cost.
That is,
if we can take 7-to-1 ratio, bring those 300 down by 7 times X, right? What does that mean from a cost savings perspective? And then Dell will be the de facto, that's who we're going to as a company.
Yeah.
So I'm really jazzed to see how that's going to be, you know, and we should hit $1 billion by next year.
Oh my gosh, so many fun predictions, Bob. I knew I could count on you for a great answer to that one.
So.
Wow, thank you so much for coming on today and for every time you come on.
It is
truly a joy. And I got to say thank you to our fabulous production team.
Our production crew is the best in the business.
Gentlemen. including the friends that we have. Curly, I'm looking at you. You saved my voice today.
Yes.
And to the whole team that was here, Dave Vellante, who's been sitting on the desk with me all week, and to everyone at Dell, who has done such a fantastic job of curating our guests and the analyst program for us. It's really just been an absolutely banner week. We hope you've had as much fun as we've had this week, wherever you might be. We're here in fabulous Las Vegas, Nevada, signing off for the last time at Dell Tech World. My name is Savannah Peterson. You're watching theCUBE, the leading source for enterprise tech news.